Sultan?
Yes.
Do you ever cook?
Yes.
No?
My wife was pregnant and it was a little bit hard.
Mm-hmm.
And then I tried to learn something. Yeah, I cook, but not as my wife cook.
Yeah.
You make it so good.
Mm.
I recommended you for a restaurant to start in Lincha.
Yeah, but the Polish country is restaurant in so I must to be. She must to be the boss, or I must to be.
It's weird. Yeah. She will be the boss. You have to learn.
Okay.
So how did you meet us?
Oh, we have a very good friendship since we were in. An island, and he entered and when we get fleet from.
Okay,
yeah. Yeah, met there. And then,
mm-hmm.
In the island, so, and then we. I'm still young, but you know, I seem to be so old because a burden of problem is in my shoulder. I must shoulder responsibility. I must save my family. I must rescued from the danger my family, from the fear of being killed, from the fear of being threatened. I must rescue them. And then I decide with my wife that, okay, there's no way for me. There's no way remained for me. Just, we must suicide ourselves and we can't go by smuggling. May we be rescued, may we not rescued. If we be rescued, we have a good future for our child. If we don't be rescued, finish. Everything is finished. I have no way to go back, of course. No way. There's no way for me. At the end, I come by smuggling to Turkey and then coming to Greece. We were in 20% in one boat in a very bad situation. We were going to sing. In a miracle situation, we have been saved. At the end, when we arrived on the beach, all of my family, my friends, my family was so happy that we are still alive. We are alive. We are alive.
Yes. هات كاري واحدة.
If I'm human, I must help someone. Someone can is here that help me. If I help them, they will help me. My plan is that I want to go to Sweden. I don't know how, by foot, but there's no way, by smugglers. When we arrived to Sweden, I don't know, doesn't they take us? Did they save us or not? I'm not sure still. Whenever they take me and then I think I'm alive, I'm human. Otherwise, still I'm not human.
هديها هديها هديها
My name is Benjamin. I work as a teacher here in Sweden. I work with immigrants who come to Sweden. So I learn, teach them my mother language. And it's super interesting. People who come here, that they need to come to another place. So I'm here to help them and to get integrated in Sweden. So I meet a lot of students. I met Sultan, that is, one of the best. He's really good. It's easy to say he's the best, but you know, it's one guy that you, from the first day, that you really start to like, and he's really into learning Swedish.
Till exempel, jag kommer från Afghanistan, jag gör en film, det kommer från Tyskland eller Grekland, och det gör en kort film, heter Fader.
Fader som pappa?
Ja, det Fader.
قشنگه بابا، فرشته کوچولوی بابا، دوست دارم بابا، دوست دارم بابا، قبول میدم بابا، بعد مدرسه با هم بریم پارک، قسم میخورم قول میدم تنهات نذارم.
The first, I really appreciate the guys that helped me too much. Since I've been in Sweden, I was searching to do something like a kind of film, and then I meet the first time lots of guys like Jan. So when I start going to film, I meet Inger, and then Inger will present me the color, and then we start film, and then I was writing, and then Inger was helping for the screen, and I was thinking, but yeah, and then they helped me, and then we select a part of that scene, and then we shoot it.
I met Sultan when he came to the church. We had a group for refugees, and we talked about the experience from the escape and how to come to a new country and all that. And then he asked me if I knew someone in Norrköping that works with film. And you have this idea with the father,
yeah,
as you say, the crazy father,
yeah.
A father full of emotions.
Yeah, the story is the father has lost 3 members of family, and then, and during journey from the Turkey to Greece, her daughter has been disappeared. He get trauma, and he's just playing with the doll. Yeah, mm-hmm, yes, mm-hmm. And he thinks imaginary. He's living imaginary, illusionary.
You have lots of connections, as you have been, yeah, here 2 years, and you have more connections now than I had in all my life. Also,
yeah,
in films.
Sultan contacted me and told me he wanted to make a movie about a traumatized father, and I was very captured by his story, and I could see it meant a lot to him to tell this story, and I tried to help him in every way I could. And Sultan wrote the script, or a synopsis first, of course, and then the script, and I think it's great. And I put him together with some filmmakers here in Norrköping. And this autumn we were shooting the picture.
I was introduced to Sultan by Inger, and I didn't know anything. But my job as a teacher in school, I work with the immigrants coming to Sweden. For me, it was maybe 50% like pedagogical work and 50% interesting story from Sultan's side. So it was two pieces, at least two pieces. That was the, and then I think it's an interesting story. I think it's an interesting story.
The first time we met, I didn't realize that the story was about Sultan's own background. And I didn't meet Sultan as a refugee. I met him as an aspiring filmmaker. Yeah.
If I would come to another country and I have an idea about doing something, but I don't have any contacts, I don't know who to speak to, so then I would like to have somebody that would help me. So maybe that's what I saw in Sultan, that he has a lot of ideas and a story, but he has nobody to speak to. And Inger was one, I was one, and now we helped Sultan to make a film. And now the film is ready, and it's like a small baby, and now you give this baby away, and let's see if this baby grew up or not. I think this is a nice example of how we can help. Maybe not finding a home or a house or like a roof to live under, but I mean doing something, getting involved in society. And for Sultan, it was important to make a film. For somebody else, it's important to play a football game. For somebody else, it's important to learn how to swim. I mean, but get people involved so they are a part of society. That's the most important thing.
It's a very universal story. And you can, with this background, you can maybe get some relief from watching the movie. And I think, in general, it's, of course, it's very powerful to write your story down or use the pictures or draw things. I think it's, you have to let it out somehow.
Sweden is going to be our home. Home is not only can say a wood or a stone. Home means that I can feel safe. This is a safe place for me, for my kids, for my wife, and we feel every calmness, quietness, and we feel peace.
I remember when you were sitting in my car and showed me your mobile with all these pictures.
Mm-hmm.
And it was a special situation. You were waiting for the letter from Migration Camp,
mm-hmm,
to if you would stay or not stay. And in a couple of days, you got this letter and you phoned me and said, no, you will have to go away.
Yeah.
And this was just before Christmas. But we said that it's impossible to send you away Christmas with a pregnant.
Yeah.
It's like a story in itself,
yeah,
you know.
It's
a story, two times, the
yeah,
Christ story. I said,
yeah.
Send you away to Hungary,
yeah,
with a pregnant wife in 8th month.
Yeah.
So we helped you to refuse. And then it said, on the TV, as on the radio news,
mm-hmm,
that now they decided for all of you that came from Hungary at that time, it stopped.
Yeah, Hungary
was. So all of you could stop staying here in Sweden until they have tried it, and you
yeah,
will have to, you could stay.
Yeah.
It was a Christmas present.
That was really amazing for me that, yeah, my wife said, oh, now I feel, everything is fine. Because it was stressed, it was almost tired of the way they wrote and terrible journey, and then it was really, since we have heard this really terrible news, and then everything was a bit crazy for me, and then, my wife, when it stopped by helping a few, oh yeah, I've never forget that day. I don't have still any interview with the immigration office. I don't have any decision. I don't have any decision. But I'm allowed to do, to work. My kids are allowed to study. At least if I don't experience of to be a child, my kids is gonna experience to be as a child in this country.
But sometimes I'm thinking that what could the decision will be to me? Are they allowed me to stay in Sweden? If they allowed me, it will be perfect. And while I'm thinking that if they don't allow me to stay in Sweden, and I cannot fight any word in this case, because if they don't allow me to stay in Sweden, it means that I'm going to die.